Welkom. In this part, we will install Xavier's excellent Blender to Unreal add-on. So, he has published this on GitHub. You'd be tempted to clone or download, but don't do it. Under installation, it has a link. Also, don't unzip it, because Blender wants the add-ons to be zipped. So, go to the location and copy it. So you can find it later in Blender more easy. So go to that location in Blender. And then you can install it from file. You can see it worked. But it still is not there because you have to restart Blender. Oh, it's still not there because you forgot to check it. So, now it's there. It gives a message that there's a new version. So, I think we should download it. Just to repeat the process. Note that now it has a 1, the name. So we select the name with 1. Yes, it works. Check. Is the check still checked? Yes. Still shows the message because we have to restart Blender again. So, now it's installed. Let's create a simple object that will represent our X, Y and Z axis. So we put it in edit mode. We want to select this face, so select faces, extract with E from extract over the XX, 2, enter, select face, E from extract over the Y axis, so Y, 2, enter, Z axis extract over Z, 2, enter. So now we want to make it pointy like arrows. So we select vertices. And we will merge them at center. So we do the same, the other. Select the vertices, merge at center. And then we have a basic arrow shape that will resemble the axis of the world. We name it something useful, so otherwise we will only end up with all kinds of cubes, so it's difficult to keep track in it. We can add materials, so I want this to each point to have the same color as the axis, so and then we also need a black for the base. So I'm just going to add the slots. And in each slot make a new material, name it, so we can recognize it later easily. And then we can select the faces and assign the colors that we want them. Of course, we have to also set a color. So these faces will be black if I assign them to black. And we can see them if we toggle the shader on, shader view. These needs to be red, so we assign them red. These faces will be blue. And these faces will be green. Okay, so now we have an object that resembles the X, Y and the Z axis. We can save this in Blender. Just any name. And now we can export it with Xavier's tool. We should set it to the Z up should be the up axis, and the X axis should be the forward axis, in my opinion. And take a note of where he puts the exports the mesh to, and you can copy this location for convenience. You can see which one is selected, the our object is selected, there are no errors. So we can export it now. You can see it's exported it. So we can quit Blender now. And see if it is, if you can import it in Unreal. So we open up Unreal. Give it any name. And we're going to use the first person shooter so we can walk around. I always put the anti-aliasing off, against the shimmering. And then from the location where Blender saved the files, you can import it. You get all the default import options. You can tweak them, but the defaults are fine, mostly. And then Unreal will start to compile the shaders. And after it's finished, the object will be ready. So, let's see if it has worked. You can see that the Z-axis and the X-axis are the same, but the Y-axis is the other way around. That's nothing we can do about it, because Blender uses the designer XIZ axis, but Unreal uses the screen XIZ axis. So, and one is a left-handed Cartesian and the other isn't, or something. Anyway, there's nothing you can do about it. So, that was it for this part. On to the next part.